did it for me. Tell somebody else, women didn't understand. Tell somebody else, say, he did it for me. your dance. It's going to sanctify. It's going to rejuvenate all the lack, everything that the enemy told you. I don't care what nobody says. This dance is a proclamation that I am the woman of God, and that nothing that's against me, nothing that's pushing me, nothing that's on my head, nothing that's down beneath has no power. For this woman of God is triumphing. This woman of God is an overcomer. She is a conqueror. She will subdue in the end. Yeah.
Thank you. Still to a long time ago.
Yes,
but you're still holding on to stuff.
Thank you, Jesus.
Asking God to set us up for our greater, but yet you ain't ready for your greater yet. How can you expect to get to your destiny still holding up the stuff that's not going to progress in your life? How in the world do you think that you can get greater or walk in victory?
Yes,
because
yes.
The thing about it, church, is that some of y'all come in here with a good dance every week, come to the altar, want folks to lay hands on you, and God said, you got the power to lay hands on yourself. I wish I had a witness in here, but it's your flesh itself that keep bringing your stuff back with you when you don't drop it at the altar. Look at somebody and say, let it go. Let it go.
Let it go.
Let it go.
Let it go.
Turn with me to the book of Ruth. We're still there. We're still there. How many people read the book in its entirety? Amen. I saw some folks were having Bible studies online. And and all of those wonderful things.
Yes, Lord.
This particular time, we're going to talk about chapters 3 and 4. Amen. Y'all bear with me because I'm flowing in the spirit today.
Amen.
Is it all right if I walk in the spirit?
Walk in it.
Here it is. We have Ruth. They have followed Naomi back to Judah. Ruth didn't know nothing about what she was about to walk into. A lot of us don't know what God has us going into a lot of times. But when you walk and operate on faith, I tell people all the time, sometimes faith makes you look like a fool. Sometimes faith makes you do things that you begin to be in fear of. But I hear God saying, don't be afraid. How in the world do you expect to go into the promise and think that everything is going to be okay? There's going to be trials that come into your life. There's going to be situations that come into your life. But you got to also understand that though that it may rain inside of us, and we have storms that come in our lives, we got to learn how to dance in the rain. Oh, I wish I had a witness in here. Look at somebody and say, you got to learn how to dance in the rain. We get dead in the rain. We get sad in the rain. Matter of fact, some of us sleep during the rain. I wish I had a witness in here. It's real good to sleep in the rain and all, but there's God saying, wake up, because there's work to do in the rain. I wish I would get it like I'm getting it right now. I understand that your relationship is falling down, but God is saying, wake up and enjoy the rain. So, we have Ruth. Now in a particular situation, because now she's in a city, in a land that she knows nothing about. All she knows is that she followed Naomi to it.
That's all.
Some of you didn't know what you were getting into when you signed up to be a part of Freeburg Cathedral of Praise. I wish I had a witness in here, because some of y'all thought that it was just going to be a good little dance, and the pastor, you know, he preaches and all, but no one expected to do the work, and no one expected to go through trials and tribulations. I wish I had a witness in here. And it's crazy, because even in our relationships, you know, they wanted you for the first thing, for everything that you had to offer. I wish I had a witness. Don't act like y'all, because you didn't look nothing spiritual. Some of y'all, at the first, you were looking at all of the outside and all of what they had and all of that they can do with what they have. I wish I had a witness. But they didn't understand that there was a process to be with you. I wish I had a witness in here. High five somebody and say, it's a process to be with me, baby. And it ain't going to always be good days. It ain't going to always be bad days. But if you learn how to just endure and stick with me through the end, baby, I wish I had a witness in here. If you just learn how to enjoy the ride, I promise you that you won't be shocked. into churches and walked into situations where all you had was a dime. All you had, matter of fact, you didn't have a dime. You just walked in faith. Knowing that God was going to do a thing. I wish I had a witness in here. Where's my faith walkers at? Then you can go to the car dealership and look at the car and say, I know I may not be qualified, but God's about to turn this thing around in my favor. I wish I had a witness in here. You done looked at your boo and said, I know that I may not be everything that you want, but I know that I am who I say I am. And that call, I wish I had a witness in here. Ruth understood because of Naomi that her Boaz was right around the corner. I wish I had a witness in here. I wish I had a witness in here that your Boaz is right around the corner. Oh my God. Your Boaz. Where my single folks at? Where my single folks at? They didn't like me before, but wait till I step around the corner. I wish I had a witness up in here. Y'all sit down. Sit down. Because y'all understand that. Y'all understand that. Matter of fact, our couples understand it too. Because you had to thank God for that edge. Because if it wasn't for the edge, you wouldn't be with where you were right now. I wish I had a witness up in. I wish I had a witness in here, because we got so many folks, so many thirsty folks in the church. Matter of fact, you know, you ain't thirsty, you dehydrated. I wish I had a witness in here. You trying to be seen by everybody, trying to wear the tightest stuff so you make sure all that's working so everybody can see what you got. Baby, it's more than that. Where's your anointing at? Where is your Holy Ghost at? Where is your prayer life at? I wish I had a witness up in here. Folks thinking that God's gonna do something. Nah, baby, if you get a job, work. Now sit down, make me nervous. Sit down, please sit.
Sad face, downhead.
Jesus.
Who's somebody?
Because see, I get tired of folks playing house. I wish I had a witness in here. Because you can't just come into my house and not expect it. You gonna do some duties in the house, take out the trash. I wish I had a witness in here, wash a dish. You know, something like that in that matter. Pay a bill. Talking about equally yoked. How in the world you equally yoked and you laying down doing nothing? I wish I had a witness.
Yeah.
know how to take order. I don't need to have to listen to God. And so, you done missed out on your bow ass because you was looking at her ass. Really was. I wish I had a witness in here. Jesus stood at the threshing floor. Now, can you only imagine being at the threshing floor and understanding what the threshing floor was? Now, let me help educate our folks, because a lot of folks hear about threshing floors and all that kind of stuff, but they don't know what takes place at the threshing floors. And so during those times at the threshing floors, what they did was they separated the wheat at the threshing floor. I wish I had a witness. Am I talking good, Dr. Mother? Okay, want to make sure I'm all right. And one that was at the threshing floor, what they would do, they would throw up the wheat in the air, and the wind would blow away all the unnecessary things. You know, one of the things I've learned about cooking from Pastor Vincent is that when you're making some beans in a pot, you got to separate all the bad beans from the good beans. I wish I had a witness in here. But my grill cooker said to understand that there's a process, you know. You gotta wash those collars. You gotta separate those pigs. I wish I had a witness. That's why you can't eat at everybody's table, because everybody's table ain't clean. Or get so happy that somebody invited you somewhere and God said, baby, stop eating at everybody's table. Woo! Everybody don't serve good meals. My God. Now sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Is this all right, church? All right. They would throw the wheat up. And the shaft would move out the way, because the unnecessary things was lighter than the wheat. Now the wheat was the profit. What in the world are you saying, Bishop? Well, I'm about to help somebody know right now. Is that the weight of God's glory is so heavy that he's blowing out unnecessary things inside of your life. But you've got to understand how to get to the threshing floor. I wish I had a witness in here. Look at somebody and say, get to the threshing floor. I wish I had a witness in here. That's why you're up in a rumble. Because God has thrown you up. I wish I had a witness in here. But God had to throw you up so the wind can blow them away. I wish I had a witness in here. You had to go through the struggle so the wind can blow you to your next purpose. I wish I had a witness. Look at somebody and say, baby, you're too heavy.
job. You wouldn't be set up for your new job. You wouldn't be set up for your new car. You wouldn't be set up for your new house. I wish I had a witness in here. I thank God for the old booze. And thank God I had to move it away. Because I know that God has something with me. Y'all sit down because it kills me because church folks be talking about why I ain't get the house and why I ain't get the book. And God said, well, have you looked at yourself lately? I wish I had a witness in here. Have you looked at yourself lately? Have you done what you're supposed to do? And I wish I had a witness in here. You talking about God enlarged my territory, but yet you don't know how to pay a tithe or an offering. I wish I had a witness in here. Baby, you curse with a curse. Huh? Can't you get the memo? Can't you see the picture? I wish I had a witness in here. And you trying to figure out why everybody else bless. Truth of the matter is that the church don't pay not one of my bills. I wish I had a witness in here. I work like a regular person work. I wish I had a witness in here. I make good money and I love making money. I wish I had a witness in here. If you learn how to put your priorities right and stop worrying about what's over in my house, maybe God will do something for you. I wish I had a witness in here.
Your territory, but you ain't prepared for it. Can't say you want a new boo and you don't look like a. You can't say you want a new job and you ain't prepared for the job. It's a process. Someone say process. It's a process. You got to work for it. Look at somebody real good and say, you got to work for it. You got to work for it. But see, the thing about the church is that everybody look at how good you do and how good you look and they worry about how you look so well and all that kind of stuff, but they don't understand that it was a struggle for me to look this good. I wish I had a witness. What my neighbor said, saying that it was a struggle for me. You don't understand my story. You don't understand my process. And so, yes, I'm supposed to look good. But if you only knew that I had 2 cents in my pocket, baby, I wish I had a witness in here, but I don't look like what I got in my pockets. I don't look like what I've been through last night. I don't look like what I went through yesterday because God. Church, how many people have been through some things this season? Am I the only one? I've been through some stuff. Didn't know how I was going to make it. But I also understand what I want the church to understand is that blessings come from the head down. And we celebrate that. Don't we celebrate that? But you don't also understand that hell comes from the head down as well. So 9 times out of 10, what happens is that when I feel like when something goes on in my life, I end up looking around the church and saying, Lord, have mercy, bless your people. Amen. And then when things start to happen inside my life, I look around and I'm starting to see people with new cars and new houses and new things that's going around. But you got to also understand that you got to work for it. Did God do anything for you? Because, see, for someone that didn't have a job, now you at the bank working. I wish I had a witness in here. God bless you. Yeah, just like that. Just like that. Just like that. He'll do it just like that. Provide for your home just like that. He'll give you everything that you need just like that. You gotta learn that you are a G, baby. I wish I had a witness in here. You can look at somebody and say, I'm a G, baby. I'm a G. I'm
OMG, baby. I'm good. I'm great. I'm glamorous. I'm all of that. I wish I had a witness. I am a G. Now, I got to encourage you, saints, because when you walk out this church, you end up looking back at the rain and end up being back at the same place, at the same struggle. So I tell people that you got to learn how to encourage yourself. Look in the mirror real good and say, I am somebody. I know that I may wait a little bit more. Matter of fact, truth of the matter is that your bishop had to get out that old robe, because I'm going to rub my hand on because I waited a little bit more. I wish I had a witness, but I thank God that the weight that's on top of me is just more for my boo to hold on to me. I wish I had a witness.
We'll be right back.
start dancing.
Thank you.
what I see in the spirit realm right now. All I see is a hurricane. And I just see just junk just being moved out of your life and unnecessary things being moved out of your situation. And I hear God saying that the weight of his glory is so heavy on your life that it had to be moved right now. You couldn't wait for tomorrow. The weight is gone right now. I wish I had a witness to understand. You hear me? Stand up, sis, right quick.
Yes.
The past had to go because God got something better with your name on it. And here's the thing. I understand that you canceled your wedding and all, but God said, don't worry about it, baby, because your new Boaz, the Boaz you're supposed to have, is right around the corner. So don't even sell it, because what God is going to do that's so spiritual is that not only are you going to have a testimony to tell folks to love themselves and not to worry about these little jokers around here, but then when you see what God has for you, you begin to dance right then, huh? Because you begin to see what God has for you is a whole bunch better, huh, than these little tricks walking around here, than the ones that are trying to take your money. I wish I had a witness in here. If you only understand that you're going through a shift, but don't be worried, don't be afraid about the shift that's going in your life. God said, step out, daughter, and watch him move. 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 Jesus. Jesus. Everybody stretch up your hands. Just tell God thank you. Tell God thank you. Lord, I thank you for what you're doing, God. I thank you, God, for what you're doing, God. Thank you for all the unnecessary things to be shifted out of my life right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, God. We thank you for your heavy weight, God. We thank you for your glory, God. We thank you for your heavy weight, God. We thank you for the glory, God. Take us to a place, God, like never before. In Christ Jesus' name, let everybody say amen, amen, and amen. Come on, clap those hands and give God glory. Listen, if you do not know who our Lord Jesus is, the time, this is your time, your opportunity to come to the altar right now and get to know who he is. Some of you have heard about him, but some of us really don't know who he really is. I dare you to come down to the altar right now and get to know him for yourself. Get to know him for yourself. Get to know him for yourself. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you are saying, Bishop, I want a church home, I want to make this my home, the altar is now open. Come on, run right now. You say, this is my home. I want to make this my church. The altar is open. Don't worry about who's sitting beside you.
Yes,
I hear God saying, you're here.
Thank you.
I hear God saying, you're here. Get up, move right now. Right now. Right now. Don't procrastinate.
Yes,
don't procrastinate. You've been sitting on it too long.
Yes.
And God saying, it's your opportunity. It's your time.
Thank
move right now.
Thank you.
Move. Move. Shut up. The good thing about this church is that not only are we equipped to take people in here, but now our church is equipped to take people all over the world.
Yes, Lord.
Y'all can give God praise for that.
Yes,
so for the ones that are watching live right now, go to the website, join Rebirth. Matter of fact, it's so simple that it prints out your certificate right there for our live members. And you'll get connected with one of our elders that's going to pray for you. And it's going to be there for you. Come on, give God glory for what he's going to expand and take place. Amen. 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 Matter of fact, while we have our elders here, certificates. Listen.
how to just move in the spirit just that way.
Amen.
Because what happens is that you end up missing what God has for you. You can't operate in fear no more. You hear me? You can't operate in fear. You can't operate. You cannot operate in fear. But because of your yes, God is starting to open up doors that you've never seen open up before. You wrote down that all you wanted was a dance, and now you can't stop dancing. I wish I had a witness in here. God will do it for you. But you gotta have the faith to just walk out, step out, and believe that he'll do it just for you with your name on it. Your name on it. With your name on it. Listen, if there's anyone now that needs prayer, come up to the altar right now. Let us pray for you. Let us pray for you. No one's here for prayer? Amen. Praise the Lord. The altar is open. Anybody for prayer? Come on up.
your seed that helps activate you. I wish I had the wisdom. That's part of your faith, is writing the seed.
Yes,
part of your faith.
Sooner or
gonna do it for you. We're a technology church, so we take Visa, MasterCard, all those good things. Put them right on your left.
Burn it, then call. She's coming.
and we got the victory over here. Come on, let's give my hand clap of praise one more time.
Oh,
is on it.